morning to all of you. Today we are going to start a new chapter. That is chapter 6, data handling. And here we are going to study the topic, that is chapter 18, statistics. Okay. So firstly, what we will study, the definition about statistic. What is statistic? It is nothing but science of average and their estimation. Statistic is nothing but the science of average and its estimation. Whenever we have to take out the average, we use statistic, or we have to calculate, or we have to find out the estimations, we use statistic. It is totally depend upon the deal of the data. So in statistic we deal with the data. Now suppose, what is data here? Suppose you are given the name of these students, 6 students are there, and you have to find out the, and total marks are given to you. Okay, so what is the data here? So this number of students is given 6 and the total marks is given to you. So this is as the data. From the data we have to calculate the statistics. Okay, so this is how we deal with the statistics here. That statistics, it deal with the data, but which kind of data? It is a some purposeful data is given to you. Suppose like population of a country or a city is given to you. From regarding that population of that city, you have to find out the questions given to you. Suppose the, what is the average population of that city, or here suppose marks of the students are given. So from here you can find out the average marks scored by each student. Okay, or who has scored the highest mark in the class, or who has scored the lowest mark in the class. Okay, so in this way, with the help of the data, we can calculate the following question which are given to you. So whenever this type of question is given, we deal to the statistics for a specific purpose. Here we will study about what is data. I told you it is a collection of numerical facts with particular information is called data. It is a collection of numerical facts with a particular information. Suppose you are given with the marks of 6 students, suppose they are in mathematics only. Okay, out of 100, these 6 students have scored this much marks in the test. So this is all what? This is data, and this is also known as observation. This particular data, this whole data, it is also known as what? Observation. Here, because this is all the numerical entries, and this numerical entries of this data is known as what? Observation, or it is also known as raw data. So you understood what is data? It is a collection of numerical facts with particular information. Numerical fact means this marks are numerical facts, and information is that particular student has scored this much marks in that particular exam, okay, or in that particular subject. So this is known as what? Data. And that numerical entries is also called as what? Observation. And with the help of this observation, we can find out that, yes, suppose it is saying how much marks Rahul has scored in mathematics subject. So Rahul has scored how much marks? 48 marks in this mathematic test. So with the help of the data here, it is easy to find out the questions which were given in the statistics. Suppose who has scored the highest marks in maths exam. So from here you can see the highest marks is 90, and who has scored this? Rohit has scored this. With the help of the particular information given in the data, we can find out the number of questions here. Next one is the range. What is range here? So the range is the difference between the lowest and the highest score is called the range. If you have to find out the range, what it is saying? The difference between the highest score and the lowest score. So highest score minus the lowest score. When you will subtract the highest score from the lowest score, you will get the range. From this above data, what is the highest score here? It is 90. And the lowest score is how much? 40. So 90 minus 40 is how much? 50. So what is the range of this particular data? Range is how much? 15. So in this way you can find out the range limit. Now the next topic here is frequency. What is frequency here? The number of times a particular observation occur is called, in a data is called a frequency. What is it is saying? The number of times, means the number of times a particular observation occurs. Particular observation means, suppose this is first observation, second, third. These are what? Observation. The number of times a particular observation is called the frequency of that. Okay, so suppose here in this table, you are given with, suppose I have to find out the frequency of 40. So see here, the 40 is repeated how many times? 1 and 2. So what is the frequency of 40? It is 2. How many times 40 is coming in this? Okay, so how many times it is repeating? It is repeating 2 times. So therefore the frequency of 40 is how much? 2. Okay, so and when you prepare it, when you prepare a table of this frequency, that table is known as what? Frequency distribution table. Okay, while solving the example, I will tell you what is frequency distribution table. For now, just to remember, what is frequency? The number of time a particular observation occurs. So 40 is occurring how many times? 2 times. So what if I write down here also 40? So what will be the frequency? It will be 3. Frequency of 40 will be how much? 3. So when you prepare a table with the help of this frequency tally marks, that table is known as what? Frequency distribution table. Topic here is frequency. What is frequency here? The number of times a particular observation occur is called, in a data is called a frequency. What is it is saying? The number of times, means the number of times a particular observation occurs. Particular observation means, suppose this is first observation, second, third. These are what? Observation. The number of times a particular observation is called the frequency of that. Okay, so suppose here in this table, you are given with, suppose I have to find out the frequency of 40. So see here, the 40 is repeated how many times? 1 and 2. So what is the frequency of 40? It is 2. How many times 40 is coming in this? Okay, so how many times it is repeating? It is repeating 2 times. So therefore the frequency of 40 is how much? 2. Okay, so and when you prepare it, when you prepare a table of this frequency, that table is known as what? Frequency distribution table. Okay, while solving the example, I will tell you what is frequency distribution table. For now, just to remember, what is frequency? The number of time a particular observation occurs. So 40 is occurring how many times? 2 times. So what if I write down here also 40? So what will be the frequency? It will be 3. Frequency of 40 will be how much? 3. So when you prepare a table with the help of this frequency tally marks, that table is known as what? Frequency distribution table. The next topic here is grouping data. Grouping data means organizing the data in the form of frequency distribution table. This table is called group frequency distribution of raw data. Suppose this data is given to you, you have to organize it in the form of group. So what is the data given to you? 4, 6, 8, 10, 15, 12 and 15. If I write down this in the term of group data, so I can write down 0 to 4, 5, 5 to 9, 10 to 14 or 15 to 19. Okay, so 0 to 4, from here 0 to 4 you will get this 4. So I am preparing frequency, I am taking your random as tally marks and here I am writing frequency. Okay, so 0 to 4, how many from here under 0 to 4 which will come? This 4 will come. So 0 to 4, 1. So 1 is there means 1 telema pair would take. Again 5 to 9, you can see 6 will also come and 8 will also come. So 2 telemas are put in. Again 10 to 14. 10 to 14 means 10 is also there and 11 is also there. And 15 to 19, 15 is there for 2 times. So for telemark 1, the frequency will be 1. For this it will be 2, 2 and 2. And total frequency you will get here as 2 to 4, 6, 7. So see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, 7 number of data are there. And we have grouped this data. 0 to 4, 5 to 9, 10 to 14, 14 to 19. No data is repeating. Okay. So this such type of table is known as what? Frequency distribution table. And when we group the data, that is known as how we are grouping this data, that is known as group frequency distribution of the raw data. This is the raw data given to you. And by the grouping method, we have find out the telemark first and then we have to find out the frequency. So in this way we distribute the grouping data in frequency data of a grouping frequency distribution of raw data. Now the next topic here is class size. What is the class size here? The difference between the upper and the lower class limit is known as the class size. Suppose here it is given 0 to 4. We have to find out the class size. So class size of 0 to 4 is the difference between upper and the lower. Means 0 minus 4, how much you will get? You will get 4. So what is the class size here? 4. Again, from here, upper is 5, lower is 9. Okay. Upper minus lower is how much? Here also you will get how much? 4. So what is the class size here? The difference between the class, between the upper and lower class limit is the class size here. Okay. Now class mark. What is the class mark? The mid value of class interval is called the mid value of class interval is called its class mark. Mid value means suppose 9 and 5. So mid value I will find 9 plus 5 divided by 2. Okay. So in this way you will find out the class mark. So 9 plus 5 is how much? 14. So 14 divided by 2 is how much? 7. So what is the class mark here? 7. So how we find out the class mark? Class mark is equal to the mid value of the class interval. That is 5 plus 9 divided by 2 equal to how much? 14 by 2, and that is 17 here.